Hello and welcome all back to the channel. Just want to say hi to all my new subscribers. It's great to have you here. And thanks to everybody who's been sharing and liking and commenting on my channel. It's helping me grow and it's greatly appreciated. So thank you very much. I will be doing a small giveaway when I hit 10,000 subscribers, which well, that's 700 off. So it's not bad. So thanks to everybody. Anyway, I just want to do a quick video here. I would like to say if anybody does comment and want any questions answered, I am going to be quite busy the next few days, so I might be slow getting back to you, but I will get back to people where I can. I'm just a little busy. So anyway, I want to take this time to look at some of the games that are on the Nintendo third parties mini direct. So part of the show was highlighting Ring Factory 5. I've never actually played any of the Ring Factory games, but I think the originals are on the 3DS and I've never played them on that. I've always looked at number 4 because it's on the Switch. So, yeah, I mean, this did look very good and I've always enjoyed Japanese anime art style games. And, yeah, I mean, this is one that's definitely on my radar at some point. It's just that then the next game they announced being Disgaea 6, that's more almost a certainty because I played those an awful lot on the Vita. So I mean I will definitely be picking up Disgaea 6, but this on the other hand is a little I'm mumming and ahhing about it because I've not played the 4th. Maybe what I'll do is I'll pick one of the 3DS games or the 4th game, see how that plays before I jump into this one. Although obviously there's a lot of differences between playing the 3DS games and, you know, a Switch game. But obviously then you're not jumping straight into a brand new full price game. You're testing the waters with an earlier game. But Disgaea 6 looked absolutely awesome. Now I played these on my Vita. I played them on a Vita and I made sure, because the trophies can be quite grindy, I didn't do it on my profile. I just played it sporadically. And that's why I find about these Disgaea JRPG turn-based type style games. They're really good just to play for like half an hour or an hour and then put down, or in between playing another like massive game that you need to put more hours into or something. Now you can play this on the train for an hour, play on your lunch break for a little, and then not bother about it for a few days. You can, you know, it's really good for that. And I've always enjoyed JRPGs that are turn-based for that reason. Like you can just play them and not really get that vested into the story and having to really sit there and play it constantly. Now, one of the big drops for me yesterday was Hades. Now, Hades from Supergiant Games was mentioned on the Nintendo Indie World Direct. That was a couple of months back. I did a video on it. It did really well, actually. Yeah, Hades is awesome because it's from the peeps that made it. The devs that made Bastion, and Bastion looks great. Was a great game. I really, really enjoyed that, and Hades looks just as good. Now, at the moment, it's digital only on the Switch and Steam, I think. However, well, it's definitely on PC. It might be on one of the other storefronts on PC. I don't really pay attention to PC games that much, but it's definitely digital only on Switch at the moment. However, what they could do is do a limited run games version of Hades. That'd be pretty awesome. I'd be all over that because I've got the Vita and the PS4 Bastion games, so this would be cool to get this for the Switch and PS4. Obviously it's not gone to the Vita, but I mean, that's a shame. But yeah, I mean, this dungeon crawler Hades is an absolute standout for the show, really, for me. So yeah, I mean, people should definitely be thinking about picking this up. And if people want a full-on review, just drop some comments down below and I'll try and find time to edit a review together. But as I said, I am quite busy over the next few days, so I might not get a review out for that. Anyway, another big stealth drop, really, from this third-party showcase was the Xbox exclusive Ori and the Will of the Wisp from Moom Studios coming over to the Switch. Now, obviously, the first Ori was pulled over to the Switch early last year, and well, it's a great game. I've got them both on the Xbox One anyway. In fact, I've got a big crazy collector's edition with art book and soundtrack and everything for the second game for the Xbox. But this is an absolutely beautiful fantasy little platform game, and it's just amazing. It really is a lovely game, and it's one of those standout hits where, you know, you ever find, if you don't have a Switch and you don't buy PC games, or you're not a Games Pass user and all this stuff, whatever, if you're wandering around soon where these people have been dumping their Xboxes off at secondhand shops to get their new Xbox, and you can pick this up and you can get a console and play this game, you should do, because it's absolutely awesome, Warriors. And I am 8-bit, I've got a crazy collector's edition as well with all these extra bells and whistles and art cards and the physical games and everything. It's really cool. So I just wanted to highlight that there as well from I am 8-bit. Anyway, two things I do want to mention on this video is that the two new Monster Hunter games were announced. Monster Hunter Stories 2 and Monster Hunter Rise. Now, I'm not going to do any video content on these two games, and I'm not going to put any sound on these two games, because every time I do any Capcom stuff, I get copyright strike, so I'm just not going to record any video or anything. But I do obviously want to highlight these two Monster Hunter games that are coming out on the Switch as well. Obviously, Stories is a sequel to the 3DS game, and I think Rise is a brand new game. I've not heard of that before, that range of the Monster Hunter games. So yeah, I do want to mention those two from the third party direct as well. So yeah, my highlights on this obviously were the Japanese side of things and Hades and Ori and the Will of the Wisp. So again, if you're new around here, please like and subscribe. And if you enjoyed this, covering what I thought of the Nintendo third party direct mini, then it's great, and thanks for everybody. Hope everybody has a good weekend, and like I say, I'm going to be doing a giveaway at the 10,000 subscribers. If you do want to comment anything down below and ask anything, then please feel free to. I might be a little bit slow at getting back to you, so thank you very much though, everybody. Goodbye.